Hi.
Doctor.
That is me.
How are you?
May we come in? No. I'm good and cold.
Well, please come in. It's a little tight in there, so you're going to curse me a little bit.
Yeah, I am going to curse you. Well, I'm not going to curse you. I'm going to curse the...
Well, it's my fault. Because I...
Oh, yeah, you decided to put this in here.
Yeah, well, it's not only that. It's... There's snow melting. There's four radiant zones. It's a complex system. That is the Burnham board.
Okay. Series 2. P205 or 206.
And
with
the,
an SL.
The stone.
Stone line. The dark water here.
Yeah. Like, what don't I have? What should be good? What can I swap out?
What don't I have is 20 pounds less weight. And then I'll be all right. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got this Burnham P20. I'm going to guess it's a 5 or a 6. Let's see. Let's see what size this boiler is.
Just 5.
I know, it just... 206. From manufacture date of April 2007. 164,000 BTU hydronic gas-fired boiler. We got a glue trap there that we're not going to step on. We got water... Top sensors everywhere.
The one thing that's been very sensitive is that low water cutoff. I've had a lot of problems.
What has it been doing?
It's not now, but over the years, that has been the failure point. If I've had to service anything, it's been that.
Well, for starters, I can't tell if it's a, it's probably a plastic shank, but there's Teflon tape on it. And that may be the sign of why this is all you're having so many problems with it, because on, you know, I'm a firm believer, if you watch my videos, of RTFM, read the factory manual, and a lot of guys don't do that, and basically, RTFM, read the factory manual, and on these low water cutoffs, like every other component of my world, comes with instructions, whether it's a single piece of paper, or it's a big, thick manual, right? But on the instructions of the most popular low water cutoffs, regardless if it's steam or hot water, it says do not use PTFE tape on the pipe threads. Use pipe sealant joint compound only. Failure to do so may cause injury and or death, right? Because the thing will malfunction. Now, I'm not too familiar with the one you have there, but I can tell you this. One of the most common parts that we replace on a hydronic heating system is a defective low water cutoff. And it's kind of like a vital safety. I get it, like a vent damper dies and it needs to be replaced. Does it really need to be replaced? Listen, if I take it out of the equation and remove the guts of it, even if I didn't have pieces of sheet metal to, you know, the flue piping to take it totally out of the equation, I can still remove all the guts for it and make it go away. The only thing it does is increase efficiency of the heating system by, I don't know, like 2 or 3%?
Right.
U.S. boiler, Whale McLean, someone prove me wrong. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am sitting here almost Indian style. Can I fit my leg there? No, not really. Let's remove the very hot combustion cover plate. Is it very hot? Yeah, it's hot. Let's just put this off to the side. Let's put that right there. Okay. Ooh, someone had a boo-boo there. Oh man, look at all the dust and sheetrock dust on these burners. Let's see. Wow. All right, Derek, I am going to pass you the burners. You wire brush them, you know, wipe them down and hit them with the WD-40. Okay. And then we'll... We'll vacuum out the combustion chamber once we... clean these. Now, there's a reason why the manufacturer tells in the manual to make sure your boiler is serviced annually by a qualified heating professional. And I say those words very specifically because you could be a plumber, licensed, certified, whatever you want to call it, and not be a qualified heating professional. Just saying. I know many plumbers in the South that have never even seen a boiler unless it was on my channel. All right, so all those are out. I'm going to get my little box wrench and we're going to remove the pilot burner tubing and the thermocouple from the gas valve. So this is a 3/8 and 7/16. I think it's called a box wrench. I just call it my little pilot wrench. It works perfectly to take out the pilot. You know what? Let's move this out of the way. Would help if I turn the gas off. Okay. The pilot tubing and our thermocouple. And you saw uncut, unedited, raw. You know, one of the first things I should have done after turning off power was killing the gas, but I did not do that. And because we're only human, I totally forgot about that. And gas was coming out of there because the pilot was still lit. And here's that one right there. We may or may not test this thermocouple. You know, we're probably gonna replace it because it looks like it's original. Let's just loosen that up. So we can get it out easier. Actually, we're gonna replace the thermocouple. Look at that tip. That tip, see that? She looks preggers. Just like a little bit, she's got a little bit in her. See that tip right there?
This is what I'm working with, folks. But sitting down, I got my sitting down on my knee pad next to the basement crickets and basement grasshoppers that ended their life tragically by probably starvation or lack of water. That's very cruel, those glue traps. But there's the combustion chamber. We're gonna vacuum that out, and then we will start wiping down all the components in the like boiler vestibule, and spraying everything down with some WD-40.
Wow, look at all that dust. A lot of sheetrock dust, just years of debris accumulating. You know, it's crazy how people spend so much money on the mechanical systems in their home, right? And then they neglect to properly have it maintained. And the common response I get, I don't want to say excuse, but the common response that I get is that, oh, we didn't know, right? It's kind of like crazy, like, you got a U.S. boiler, Burnham Alpine, or like a Lochinvar, right? These machines, you know, come with these pamphlets on how to service them, you know, which needs to be done on an annual basis, you know, which takes a good couple hours to do, you know, and you need, you know, $5,000, $6,000 worth of maintenance per year. I get it. It defeats the purpose of having this high efficiency equipment, but what you save in energy, you're going to spend in maintenance, but still, service your equipment, ladies and gentlemen. Even if it's every other year, do something. Something is better than nothing. But this homeowner, you know, he's been begging his plumber to come service this. Like, nah, it's fine, it's working, you know? But I don't know. Look at this. That's just loose as a goose. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. So, wiping her down, right? And as soon as I'm done with this, I'm gonna spray everything down with some WD-40, wipe it clean, and I'm gonna show you a 90-day difference here. All right, I'm not even gonna mess around with testing the old thermocouple. Oh, what happened there? You never cleaned out the pilot burner. Now, that's clean. So as I was saying, I'm not even going to test the output of the thermocouple, the existing thermocouple with millivolts, and see how much that pilot is generating. I'm just gonna throw a new one on there. Let's reinstall and then show you how this thing looks glamorous after reinstallation of all the burners. Just saying, you can always tell when a professional was working on a gas control system versus someone that doesn't really take pride in the work. Look at that. That could be a little bit better though. Let's move this, separate a little bit more right there. Look at that. Beautiful. And last but not least, come on. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Clean as a whistle. Pilot, let's hold that down for a minute. By the way, this thing's like 10 bucks on Amazon. Little Jet Pro. See? Watch how we finesse this. There's the pilot. Hold this down for about 60 seconds. And then we should be good. Sweet. Let's put the front plate of the combustion chamber, reconnect the rollout switch, and then clean exterior boiler. We'll send Derek in here to do that. Spray everything down, and then we'll fire it up and check temperature and pressure, relief and expansion, combustion. Now, a couple pro tips. The burner that has the pilot burner on it only goes in a specific location. Sometimes it's marked, pilot burner is mounted here. Here there was a little piece of, a little touch of, looks like pink tape, or sorry, pink paint, but also there on that one as well. But I know it's gonna fit there because there's a separation between these two burners, which is gonna accommodate that pilot burner assembly. So that's one tech tip. The other one is when you reinstall the flame rollout switch, the two wires, make sure they're not touching the metal because that will eventually melt and you'll short out either the transformer or if there's a fuse, you'll blow that. But pilot is lit. We'll turn this to on. And just for testing purposes, let's just fire up. The damper is going to go through its sequence of opening and then closing. Or sorry, closing then opening because it was turned off. Power turned off during an on cycle. So that's going to close. And then if there's a call for heat, it's going to open. Wait for it, folks. Wait for it. Unless the house is filled with Nest thermostats. Or the boiler's at temperature. Yeah. We'll come back to that. All right. I tasked Derek with doing a good cleaning of all the exterior components of this hydronic heating system. Now, the customer also wanted us to do maintenance on the indirect water heater by Burnham. This is the 50 SL. This is a stone line tank. This tank is heavy, very, very heavy. And live streaming, we have 95 people watching, only 24 thumbs up, but come on guys, 24, why are you disrespecting me like that? There's only 24 people. Hit that thumbs up button, and it is 95 people watching right now. Are you guys like stupid or something? Anyway, we have ACIQ in the house. We have Nicole from ACIQ. We have Devin. We have a bunch of other long-term subscribers to the channel. All right, what we need to do now is a valve tag on the gas supply for the boiler. The water feed for the boiler. Cold water. Ooh, that's not cold water. That is, I don't even know what that is. This is probably cold water. They probably have a recirculating system here. It's so hot. Yeah. Let's put a valve tag on that and that. Yeah, and then maybe, just maybe, we'll sign them up for a maintenance plan. Very, very nice. Very, very nice. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. And hit that notification bell. Get post notifications when I drop a video. Sweet.